Daniel and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be painting with M. Grand gouache, and if you don't know what M. Grand gouache is, it's more of the professional line of gouache. And I've been looking for videos on YouTube and I haven't really seen that many people talking about the M. Grand gouache. They usually talk about the M. Grand watercolors. So today should be interesting. Let's see what we draw and how I like these. Today I will be working on my Artessa sketchbook, and finally we're gonna be painting the first page after a long time. I've been excited to do this. So yeah, today I already prepared my canvas. I took a little thalo blue and watercolor and diluted it down so that I could have something to work off of, so I don't have to go off of the white of the paper. So let's get started and I hope you enjoy. Hey guys, so right here I just wanted to show you guys the quick time lapse of how I get my proportions in at first, and this is just a little bit of the gouache diluted down, and I use this for setting up myself for my painting. And honestly, I find it easier than doing it with a pencil. When you do it with a pencil, you kind of get lost in the details and you might add stuff that you wouldn't want with a brush, and you would be more copying the image instead of interpreting what you see. So I just wanted to show you this quick step before I hopped into the time lapse.
Wait, now bump. Wait, now bounce. Wait, now bounce. Wait, now bounce.
Let me hit it from the back. Put your back into it. Hit it from the back.
Welcome back, everybody. So far, I wanted to bring you guys along to where I was at. And at this point, I have put most of my colors in, and I'm gonna start working more on the face and on the hair because the hair is really undeveloped. I didn't want to go that dark with the hair because I didn't have the background that I wanted. But at this point, I already set up my background so it could be like I'm getting a silhouette. And I'm ready to get started on the hair and defining the features. I would say that this is about 60% done. I still have to work on the ear right here that I haven't finished, and I have to work on the cloth. The cloth is gonna be the trickiest part because I'm not used to drawing like that much clothes. I usually draw portraits, which means that I don't really have to draw much. I could leave that as an abstract shape, but I want to put some details into the cloth and try to make it look like it's wrapping around my shoulders. Also, I am going to be working on the other arm because it's barely visible and I need to make it so it could pop out a little bit more. And working with the Zorn palette has really been teaching me how to work with my brush strokes and how to get the most efficient brush strokes, because usually how I'm working with most of my colors, I don't have to worry about what colors I put down, because I could just switch it or change the value of it and it won't really affect my piece, because once I usually mix with my primary colors and everything's much easier. Now I'm learning how to not go too light too fast, which is a problem that I've been having for most of the time that I've been drawing. But I started this one with my darkest values, and then I brought it up and I really enjoy doing it like this. So we're gonna keep on moving along, we're gonna keep on adding details now and fixing things, and I hope you enjoyed so far what we've done. But let's keep it moving. Welcome back again, everybody. Right here, you just saw me taking off the ear, well, erasing it basically, and all I had to do was take a little damped napkin and rub it out, and all of the pigment came off. And that's what I really like about these paints, that I don't really need to fuss around that much. It's not that permanent, and I could come back and work on it at any time that I want, and it's like brand new. And I really enjoyed using these. I didn't see any limitations when I was using them. Like, the paints acted like I don't know how to describe it, but basically the best way that I would describe it is that the price point for these paints make a lot of sense now, because when I was using them, they felt so good to use and I felt so comfortable using them, and I didn't have to do stuff that I've had to do in the past, which is go over layer by layer and readjust a lot of the colors and fuss around a lot. I really didn't have to do that this time. Once I basically got the handle of it and how much I was supposed to dilute the paint when I was starting out, because it got so much pigment in it that you at first you don't know how much water you use in order to dilute it so that you could build up the layers, because even if you add a lot of water, the pigments are still really, really opaque. So these are just light layers on the paper. I didn't even use that much paint, to be honest. But I really enjoyed using these. I would recommend anybody who is interested in gouache paints to go ahead and buy these, because these are great and I feel like they're a bang for your buck. And I also feel like if you had any doubts, like, well, I could just buy like the cheaper brand and I'll get the same results, I honestly don't believe that you would, because with this brand compared to my Art Himimiya brand and to my designer gouache, this is the brand that I feel like I'm gonna be using more often, mainly because is so comfortable to use and I feel like they're so easy to blend. And with these, I barely run into the problem that I need to fight to remix the same colors again, because I believe that these gouache paints are made only by using the pigments and not adding any white to them, so they don't dull down once they dry. So pretty much this piece has been done for like about 48 hours now and the colors are basically the same. So I really enjoyed making this. Tell me what you think. I'm gonna leave you alone. Remember to rate, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to follow me on my social media. The link will be down in the description. But tell me what you think about these if you have used them before. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace. And I'm out. We'll be right back.